Hello everyone, welcome to My Dreams Academy. Today we are going to see TS-NPDCL Sub-Engineering Paper Explanation. Question number 1, percentage differential protection is used to prevent. This question is from power systems. Option A, interturn fault. Option B, heavy fault. External fault, magnetizing current. Okay, that percentage differential protection. Percentage differential protection is used to prevent intertern fault. Now we are going to see question number 2. That is question number 2. The function of steel wire in ACSR conductor is used to. ACSR is nothing but aluminium conductor steel reinforced. Aluminium conductor steel reinforced. In this, the steel is used. Okay. Generally, the conductor is like this. Will have number of strings like this. In the middle one is steel. Due to skin effect, okay, the current density is high at the surface of the conductor. And the current density is very less at the inner layer of the conductor. So if you use aluminium over there, it will waste of aluminium cost. Then we use, instead of aluminium, we use steel. Okay. So current density at the center of the conductor is less, at the center of the conductor is yes. So we use steel. So another advantage of steel conductor is it will provide additional mechanical strength. To the conductor. Okay, it will not use it to compensate the skin effect and it will not take care about the surges. It will not reduce the inductance of the conductor. Okay, this is what the function of steel wire in ACSR conductor. Now we are going to see question number 3. This question is from SAGE calculations from the power system. This question is all about SAG calculation. The SAG formula S is equals to omega L square by 8T, where omega is nothing but omega or W is nothing but weight of the conductor. Next, T is nothing but tension of the conductor. Now I am going to read the question. The sag of conductors of a transmission line, the sag is given, that is 2.5 meters. When the span, okay, span is nothing but length, L is equals to 250 meters. Now if the height of the supporting towers, are like this, this is the length and this is the sag, S. Now height of the supporting towers increased to 25%. Okay, now the sag will be, option A, reduce by 25%. Option B, increased by 25%. Option C, reduced 12.5%. Option D, remains unchanged. Actually, the sag of the conductor, does not depending upon the height of the conductor. So it will remains unchanged. When the height of the conductor is increased to 25%, so sag does not change on the basis of height of the conductor. Next, we are going to see question number 4. This question is also from power systems. Fourth one. The insulator used on 132 kV. Insulator used on 132 kV transmission lines is generally option A pin type, option B disc type, option C shackle type, option D that is pin and shackle type. Okay, so if the rating of the conductor is 132 kV, if the rating of the conductor is 132 kV, we use disc type insulators. If the rating of the conductor is less than 33 kV, we use pin type insulators. Then the shackle type insulators will be used at a dead end. Dead end connections. So dead end daggara manam shackle type insulators anedi vaadtam. Next question number 5, corona loss increase with. This question is about corona loss. So the corona loss formula is this one. Corona loss formula, that is 242.2 F plus 20 by, where F is the frequency of the conductor, under root of R by D, where R is the radius of the conductor and D is the distance between the conductors. And next this is what V minus VD whole square into 10 to the power of minus pi. So this is kilowatt per phase. Okay, kg for kilowatt per phase. Here now I will read the options. Corona loss increase with, corona loss increase with decrease in conductor size and increase with in frequency. Okay, corona loss is decrease in conductor size and increase with the frequency. First of all, we are going to see, if the frequency of the conductor increases, then what happened to the corona loss? The corona loss will be increased. Okay, if the frequency increases, corona increases. And if the radius of the conductor increases, corona losses increases. But this is the wrong. Okay, sir, how you can tell that, sir, these two are in directly proportional, then why you are not giving it as a wrong? Okay, sir, idu enduku wrong ani cheptunnaru meeru ante okka sari chudandi. Critical descriptive voltage VD, okay, VD, we need to calculate VD value. So we know electric field intensity E is equals to V by R into ln D by R. This is the electric field intensity formula. From this, V is equals to E into R into ln D by R. Whenever radius of the conductor increases, VD value increases. If the VD value increases, so V minus VD value decreases. Corona loss will decrease. So don't come to conclusion that if the radius of the conductor increases, corona loss increases. This is the wrong perception. The corona loss will be decreases. So whether so manaku formula nundi chuste corona loss anedi directly proportional to resistance, directly proportional to radius of the conductor undi, but also it depends upon the critical descriptive voltage. VD is equals to E into R into ln D by R, where R is the radius of the conductor. Now I will read the options. Option A, decrease in conductor size. If the conductor size If the conductor size increases, corona loss will decrease. Yes, correct. Increase in frequency, supply frequency. If the supply frequency increases, corona loss increases. So option A is only correct. Okay, it will decrease if the radius of the conductor increase, as well as the frequency increases, corona loss also increases. Corona loss also increases. Now, okay, so this is kilowatt for phase. The units of this one is kilowatt per kilometer per phase. And next, the units of this one is kilowatt per kilometer per phase. Next, we are going to see question number 6. The inductance of single phase 2 wire power transmission line per kilometer gets double. First of all, we are going to see inductance formula. Inductance is equals to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 ln GMD divided by GMR. GMD ante geometrical mean distance, that is nothing but the distance between the two phases, and GMR is nothing but geometrical mean radius. Geometrical mean radius. Now here my inductor wants to be double. My inductor wants to be double. So inductor value double kavalante, if a GMR value double ayindi, if the GMR value double ayindi anukundam, double aithe inductor value double avutunda? No. Endukosam ante idi directly relation lo ledu. So we have one more component, that is ln. Ln is nothing but natural logarithmic. Natural logarithmic. So idi double kavalante, if inductor value wants to be double, if the inductor value wants to be double, it should be square times. It should be square times. Sare ela deni represent cheyachu? Ln x. So ln x square. So dintla square undi. If you wanted to take out, that is ln x square. So we can able to write 2 into ln x. So inductor value double kavali ante GMR value should be square times. Now I will read the options. So option A, when it is doubled. So when GMD is doubled, inductor value does not double. Okay. Second one, wire is increased to 4 times. If the wire increased to 4 times, the inductor value does not depends. Next, option 3, wire is increased as square of the original distance. As the square of the original distance. Okay. If the distance is square of the original distance, then the inductor value will be doubled. Then the inductor value will be doubled. Next, question number 7. So option C is correct for this one. Next, the capacitance of the overhead transmission lining is increased. So capacitor formula I will go into right now. C is equals to 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon r divided by ln GMD divided by r. So ikkada manam GMR anedi rayakodadu. GMR calculation is only for inductor, not for capacitor. GMR value is only for inductor, not for capacitor. So now option A, so increase in mutual geometrical mean distance. First of all, I'll read the question. The question is, the capacitance of overhead transmission line is increased with. So capacitor value should be increased. So increase in mutual geometrical mean distance, if this is increased. Okay, if the distance is increased, if the distance is increased, increase the mutual geometrical mean distance. Geometrical mean distance increase aite, geometrical mean distance increase aute, so this value increases, capacitor value decreases. Capacitor value decreases. Next, increase the height of the conductor. Increase the height of the conductor. So capacitor value can be calculated like this, that is epsilon A by D. If the distance between the two parallel plates increases, capacitor value decreases. So ikkada em antundo, increase in the height of the conductor above the ground wire. So height of the conductor increase ayindante distance anedi increase avutundi. So capacitor value decrease avutundi. So idi second option anedi wrong. Next, increase in the mutual geometrical mean distance. So geometrical mean distance increase avutunde, mean distance increase avutunte, so deeni value em aitundi nana, దీని వాల్యూ కూడా ఇంక్రీజ్ అవుతుంది, కెపాసిటర్ వాల్యూ డిక్రీజ్ అవుతుంది. సో నో ఆప్షన్ ఈజ్ కరెక్ట్, బోత్ ఆప్షన్ ఏ ఆప్షన్ బి ఆర్ ఫాల్స్. నౌ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు గివ్ యూ క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 8. సో క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 8 ఈజ్ ద కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్లీ షార్ట్ మీడియం లాంగ్ లైన్ ఈజ్ ప్రైమర్లీ బేస్డ్ ఆన్. ఓకే, ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు గివ్ యూ షార్ట్ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్, మీడియం ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్, లాంగ్ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్. సో షార్ట్ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్ ఈజ్ అప్ టు 80 కిలోమీటర్ అండ్ మీడియం ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్ ఈజ్ ఫ్రమ్ 80 కిలోమీటర్ టు 250 కిలోమీటర్స్ అండ్ లాంగ్ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్ ఈజ్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్ 250 కిలోమీటర్స్. ఓకే, అండ్ వన్ నోట్, దట్ ఈస్ దిస్ క్లాసిఫికేషన్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ అప్లికేబుల్ ఫర్ 50 హెర్ట్జ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ. దిస్ క్లాసిఫికేషన్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ అప్లికేబుల్ ఫర్ 50 హెర్ట్జ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ. నౌ ఐ విల్ రీడ్ ద ఆప్షన్స్. ఓకే, సో ద కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్లీ షార్ట్ మీడియం లాంగ్ లైన్ ఈజ్ ప్రైమర్లీ బేస్డ్ ఆన్, ఫస్ట్ వన్, నార్మల్ వోల్టేజ్ ఆఫ్ ద లైన్. నో. నెక్స్ట్, ఫిజికల్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ద లైన్. నెక్స్ట్, వేవ్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ద లైన్. నెక్స్ట్, పవర్ ట్రాన్స్మిటెడ్ ఓవర్ ద లైన్. యాక్చువల్లీ దిస్ క్లాసిఫికేషన్ 80 కిలోమీటర్ అండ్ 80 to 250 కిలోమీటర్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్ 250 కిలోమీటర్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ అప్లికేబుల్ ఫర్ 50 హెర్జ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ. ఇఫ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ చేంజెస్, దిస్ క్లాసిఫికేషన్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో చేంజెస్. సో ఇట్ డస్ నాట్ డిపెండ్ అపాన్ ద ఫిజికల్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ద కండక్టర్, ఇట్ విల్ డిపెండ్ అపాన్ ద వేవ్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ద కండక్టర్. The frequency changes, wavelength also changes. So it will depending upon the wavelength of the conductor, not depending upon the physical length of the conductor. So wavelength of the conductor is correct. Option 3 is correct. Next one, question number 9. So velocity of propagation of electromagnetic waves on overhead transmission line. This already we know, that is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Next. So option A is correct for this one. Next, question number 10. That is, under no load condition, the current in the transmission line is because. ఓకే, యాక్చువల్గా నో లోడ్ కండిషన్లో కరెంట్ షుడ్ నాట్ బి దేర్ ఇన్ ద సెండింగ్ రిసీవింగ్ ఎండ్ సైడ్. ఓకే, సో మనకి నో లోడ్ కండిషన్లో కూడా రిసీవింగ్ ఎండ్ దగ్గర కరెంట్ అనేది ఉంటుంది. దిస్ ఈజ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్, ఒకసారి మనం ఇది చెక్ చేద్దాం. ఓకే, దిస్ ఈజ్ మీడియం ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్, దిస్ ఈజ్ మీడియం ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్ అండ్ దట్ టు పై నెట్వర్క్. ఇఫ్ దేర్ ఈజ్ నో లోడ్, Load is open circuited. At the open circuit, the current should not be there. IR value is equals to 0. But at the no load condition, there is some current in the receiving end side. Just because of this person. What is that? Because of capacitance. Now I will read the question again. Under no load conditions, the current in the transmission line is because of. Under no load condition, the current in the transmission line is because of option A, that is capacitance effect, option B, that is corona effect, option C, proximity effect, option D, that is backflow from earth. So which option is correct? Option A is correct, that is capacitance effect. So option E is correct. This is what about 1 to 10 questions. In the next video, we are going to do 11 questions from 20 questions. In the very nearer future, we are going to start one new batch for sub engineering electrically separately. We are going to inform the details, and if you want any queries regarding this there is a one number in the description, you can call to that number. Thank you all.